Hello there, fellow summoners. Mad Dog HT here, and we're back in another Alliance War. This is the back half of season 28, War number 7. We're up against WAK, Wakanda. I have a pretty light assignment for today. I have Path 1. It's got Vigorous Assault and Arc Overload with this Hit Monkey, and I did put on an invulnerability boost. And I just went in with my white Magneto. So my white Magneto is rank 2, and I felt like he would probably be the safest and the quickest option. Now I could have probably used Thing. I would have shied away from using Torch just because if I did get hit big and with a bleed, then that could really, really mess me up. But both Thing and white Magneto is they're both bleed immune, and so my whole plan was just to wait out the arc overload, keep this guy to his special one, and I wasn't gonna knock him down until I knew basically my special 3 would kill him. I just didn't want to deal with his monkey madness stuff where he can evade and shrug off stuff, which you wouldn't have been able to shrug off the stun. And yeah, maybe I could have been a little bit more aggressive, but you can see that I don't take any hits. Probably took a little bit more time than needed, but overall, time, for me personally, I'm not too concerned with it. I'm more concerned with making sure that you get the attack bonuses, and so it's really not something in the back of my mind, but we take that guy out. It took about 2 minutes. Not fast by any means, but didn't get hit. Pretty much finished with full health. And yeah, we're going to move on. There wasn't any champ on the masochism node, so I didn't do that. And then for this mojo, I do apply my human torch pre-fight, but I wasn't assigned that fight, so I had somebody else. McCloud 33, he used it, and then he used his pre-fight elsewhere, just because I had such a light assignment that I did have one mystic fight, but I didn't need it. But here's node 24, EMP modification, aspect of evolution, bubble shield, and burden of might, and I'm going in with Thing. I do apply a regen boost, which, you know, really wasn't too necessary, but I have so many of these 3-minute boosts that I feel like I've just been able to use them a lot more readily, you know, even though I really felt like I didn't need it. So as far as this fight goes, you know, Burden of Might is going to limit the power that I get, but that's okay because Thing with Human Torch on the team, he can build up his rock stacks and convert those into furies every time I get a block. I just need to keep track of that bubble shield, which, you know, for Thing, you do want to block a lot. But, you know, here we go. So we got to 10, and then we just got to dex one time, and it's got to be a regular attack. It can't be the special attack. That unblockable won't go away. And then I'm just trying not to block while he is in invisible. And you know, I do kind of end up getting cornered over this way a little bit. I wanted to keep him to his special ones, but I was like, oh, I'll just end up pushing him to his special 2, just because I could block all this while I had some bubble shield charges. And yeah, I just didn't want to get close to 20 and then try to block that and get wrecked or whatnot. So we're almost back up to 20 charges. And we'll have to dex that. So this next one I have to dex. It's unblockable. Missed it right there. We get an intercept in there. And then there we go. We got off that 20th unblockable. Wait out the cloak. And then just go to town. So, you know, the block penetration gets pretty real as this guy keeps getting specials and the power gain. And I do get over here in the corner. But we're able to clean it out. Pretty easily. We end up losing 25% health, and not too big of a deal. And on this one, we're going up the middle, on the left side, path 2, node 31. It's got the strike counter, combat power rate, and power drain. Really nothing going on this node. This is where, you know, they were like, oh, you can use the pre-fight on that. I'm like, I don't need the pre-fight for this one. So that's why I gave it away to the Mojo. And here I'm just gonna do parry, medium, light, medium, and this long shot will go down super, super quick. I do get off one special. I still do have that regen boost active from that last EMP fight. And yeah, this guy's just gonna take a couple more combos and he will be dead. Just need to make sure that I don't eat one of those L1s, block it, get some extra smolder. Long shot melts super quick, 20 hits. And we move on to this Annihilus on node 41. This has the strike counter, combat power rate as well, and stung once, twice shy. So I do need to be aware of me getting a bar of power and not throwing it until that power sting is gone. And so I do start with a power start one boost. And I have a lot of these boosts that are like overflowing and I'm still buying them just so that I can use them. I just want to make sure that I can get whatever advantage I can in war. And I wanted to start with the power start one simply because it's really nice to throw and nullify Annihilus's rod. That way you can stun him without any problems. You know, he can come in as long as it's not an obliterating strike. You can get your decks or not decks. You can get your parry on. But if it's an obliterating strike, that's when he starts getting those stifles and armor breaks. Granted, the thing is immune to the armor break, so I do get the stifles. And I am trying to manage my combo here, and I'm gonna get off another special one. And I'm gonna nullify the rod again. And there we go, allows me to get some easy ins. And you know, every once in a while I'll get stifled, not a big deal. Thing can hit through the unstoppables if he throws a special. He gets that light blue passive buff that can eat through unstoppables. Did take a hit there just a bit back, but really not a problem at all. Intercept him with a special one and pretty much finished with full health. Pretty easy fight for Thing. And then last up we have Moleman on the buffet strike counter combat power rate. It's also got the Chitnous, Thorns, and Outlast. So I do apply my white Magneto pre-fight on this, that way I can get reliable stuns. And I still do have that power start one boost active. I think I do get to a special two and I fire that off so I can convert a bunch. But I am gonna stun him and I do make the mistake and I rush in thinking that I would have enough time, but he does shrug that off. So I do get hit, not a big deal, didn't hurt that bad. Thing is also shock immune, so the L1 shock, I'm not gonna get any lingering effects from that. And I'm gonna block a lot of his specials. I could be dexing it, but I'm just gonna block it so that I can build up rock stacks and furies even faster. That's where I'm gonna get my damage from. And that one I mistimed. But again, it didn't do much of any damage. And yeah, we're just gonna keep going. I think I end up pushing him to trigger his monster, his frenzy. But I think it's towards the end, I believe I get it, because I keep managing the combo and I'm able to keep throwing special ones off. And because I have Human Torch on the team, I do get an incinerate, then he can shrug that off. So we're almost to a quarter wave left. Throw off another special one, he's gonna shrug off the weakness and the incinerate. He's up to 16 charges. Thing is hitting max potential. I do have the class disadvantage, but this only took about 2 minutes. He doesn't even get to frenzy. So here we go, one more hit. Yeah, 2 minute fight, not fast, but that's what Thing does. Thing just smashes, and even though it takes a little bit, he's a great counter. And then I didn't have any assignments on Mini Island, but I had helping to taxi and get some pre-fights on for Ultima Theory. He took down that Bishop with an AA, and then Dems, he took down that Terax with his Claire. I apply a white Magneto to the Spider-Ham, and Ultima takes down that with his AA. And then last up, we have this Apocalypse boss. And now this is Werewrym in our group. He is an incredible player. He actually, I believe he was the second place winner in the US region for the third week in the Summoner Showdown. Happy McStuffins was the number one guy, but I think he won week two. So by default, he won the round three. So I think he's gonna be seen at the Summoner Showdown. So good luck to him. He is a great player, and he's gonna be a force to reckon with for sure at that Summoner Showdown. But here he's going in with his Guillotine 2099, and he is trying to get him to bait some heavies to get some openings, and make sure he doesn't lose the combo. And then he's just pushing him to a lot of L1s, and he's doing a Dex blocks Dex method on the L1 evades, which is very, very clean. You know, you only take one block damage instead of doing like a block Dex or blocking it all. And so it's like on this rank 3 Apocalypse, it's like, what was that, 2300 damage? So it's not that much. Guillotine doesn't take a ton of damage from that special. And, you know, she still has that regen at the end if you need it. And the one thing that Werewrym is doing is he is throwing off his L2 basically right before he gets to L3. And one thing that will do is give you more damage on all of those hits from the special two. So the later that you can throw that special two, you know, you got, it's a ton of hits on the special two. I think it's like, I don't know, 8 hits? No, I just looked back, it's 9 hits. So yeah. And then, you know, as your combo keeps building up, you get that energy damage from every hit. So, you know, if you can get off a special two with more hits in your combo, you're gonna get more damage from that. And the one nice thing is, you know, you used to have APOC with a lot of the protect global nodes, and you really couldn't throw a special one. You can see the last one he did throw a special one. You know, it's kind of nice if you need some power control. You know, you can push him to special three, throw a special one, and drain him right below 2 bars, which is really, really nice. And I think he thought that he had hit special two there. It would have definitely killed him, but the L1 didn't. But yeah, he finishes off very, very clean fight. Gets the solo. We've soloed all the bosses so far this season, and we did win. Wakanda, good job to them. They died quite a bit at the end when they kind of saw that it was out of reach. But we had 8 deaths total for the Alliance, which is pretty good, but we need to do better. I know we can do better for sure. But yeah, as far as my stats go, I had 5 fights, 5 kills, no deaths on the season, 44 fights, 43 kills, 3 deaths, and we only moved up 2 spots in Platinum 1. Is, I guess, you know, the matchups and everything, how it shook out. You know, we didn't get a lot of movement going on. I think a lot of the guys that were above us were fighting people that were below us, so we didn't get a lot of movement, and they won, obviously. But you know, we're on a good streak. We're 5-2 on the season with a 5 consecutive win streak. So we're gonna hopefully keep that up. We need to keep winning because we need to climb a lot of spots, and we'll check out the leaderboard kind of closer to the season end and see where we might fall depending on what we do. But yeah, we're doing all right. We started slow, but we're cruising now. But yeah, thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed, and I'll see you fellas in the next one. Peace out.